What's the deal with the pink stuff today?
Oh, were our guys wearing pink?
Oh, well, like this thing was pink.
Oh, that might have been. That's left over from the last. Oh, it's not left over, but it's like that play for K. It's like Think Pink Month.
I didn't get the onion, did I?
Oh, man.
I'm a mess.
Bulls in Toledo tonight at Alumni Arena. Josh Plutzel with you, joined by John Fuller, assistant AD at UV, charge of athletic communications. John, welcome to the broadcast tonight. What have you got for us here pregame?
Some real hard-hitting information for you, Josh. No, definitely a big game for the Bulls. You know, they obviously at home need to get this win because where they are in the standings, kind of right now tied for fifth, real logjam right now. So obviously, you know, Akron and Ohio are at the top of this, but they have a chance to win this important game and kind of sort of separate themselves from the lower tier of the conference.
Yeah, the Bulls 4-6 in MAC play, but a home MAC tournament game still very much a possibility for UB.
Without question. And you have to remember, with Toledo, we talked about earlier, on probation, and they cannot play in the MAC tournament. So there's actually going to be five byes to Cleveland this year. Right now, Buffalo is tied for fifth, so there's no question they continue to play well. They can get that bye and go right to Cleveland.
Oh, yeah, forget about a home game.
Right, so that's obviously the goal of this team, but obviously a home game would be good as well.
All right, that's our game preview brought to you by Time Warner Cable. Enjoy basketball better with Time Warner Cable. Get in the game and stay connected to your teams with TV, internet, and home phone. Bulls and Toledo just around the corner. UB trying to defeat the Rockets for the fifth straight time, and we'll return with our starting lineups and tonight's opening tip-off right after this. You're listening to Buffalo Bulls Basketball on the UB Basketball Network.
Check out more than 20 new items, including multi-drive and new
Hey.
Thank you. Let's meet the starters for Toledo. At guard, number one, Dominique Buckley. At guard, number five, Ryan Pearson. At guard, number 20, Julius Brown. At forward, number 43, Matt.
Time for the starting lineups tonight, presented by Wendy's. First for visiting Toledo, coached by Todd Kowalczyk. At guard, Dominique Buckley, a 6'2 senior from Romulus, Michigan. 9.3 points a game for Buckley. He ups that to 11 points per game in MAC competition. Also at guard, the team's leading scorer, Ryan Pearson, 6'4 junior from Raytown, Missouri, just outside Kansas City, averaging 18.6 points per game. That's the most in the MAC, 6.6 rebounds a game. That is eighth best in the conference. Their point guard is Julius Brown, Juice Brown, a 5'10 sophomore from Markham, Illinois, last year's MAC Freshman of the Year, 13.5 points per game, 5.6 assists a game. Pearson and Brown, the highest scoring tandem in the MAC. At forward, Matt Smith, a 6'7 junior from White Wright, Texas. He's averaging 9.6 points a game and is shooting better than 40% from the three-point arc. Both Smith and Pearson began their college careers playing for Todd Kowalczyk and his previous school, Wisconsin Green Bay. And at center, one of the best freshman big men in the MAC, Nathan Booth, a 6'9 first-year player from Gurnee, Illinois, averaging just under 8 points a game and 5.2 rebounds a game. And there's a lineup for Toledo. Now the lineup for Buffalo, starting at point guard Jaron Skeet, 6'3 freshman from Brampton, Ontario, 5.7 points a game for Jaron, 9 points a game, though, in MAC competition. Tony Watson is a 6'2 senior guard from West Palm Beach, Florida. He's averaging 8.8 points a game, 3 assists a game, and over the last 5 games, averaging almost 12 points per game. Interesting stat for Tony Watson since getting plugged into the starting lineup 7 or 8 games ago. He's averaging 38 minutes a game. At the wing, Oran Nwariunk, a 6'6 junior from Baltimore, 6.2 points a game and 5 rebounds a game for Oram. Yvonne McRae starts at forward, 6'7 junior from Newark, New York, 17.1 points a game, 7.5 rebounds a game for Javon. And Will Regan starts at forward, 6'8 third-year sophomore from the Nichols School in Buffalo, 10.3 points a game and 4.5 rebounds a game for Will Regan. Those starting lineups are brought to you by Wendy's. Stop by Wendy's after the game. Their drive-thru's open until midnight or later. Now that's better. The officials for tonight's game, Glenn Mayborg, Kevin O'Connell, who's from Rochester, and Pat Driscoll. And we're just about set for basketball now. Josh Wetzel with you, along with John Fuller, Mike Klein in the studios. And John, you pointed out this is a very big game for the Bulls, trying to hold serve at home against a Toledo team that has won 3 road games so far in the MAC. They've been able to win at some tough venues on the road.
You know, 3 MAC road games, including 5 in a row, but they've won at Ball State, at Northern Illinois, and at Kent State. Yep. And obviously it's not something that Buffalo has never been able to do, so that says a lot about their team. But yeah, very important game tonight for the Bulls, and very important, I think, to get their offense back on track. They really struggled. They had a great game a couple weeks ago here against Central Michigan when they put up 91 points. But since then, they've just really struggled offensively, scoring 60 at Western Michigan, then 46 at Eastern Michigan, and then 59 against Northern last week. So I think, you know, they're looking forward to really moving the ball and getting into their offense early here and get some points on the board.
Javon McRae will be jumping center for the Bulls against Matt Smith for Toledo. Bulls in their home white, trimmed in blue. Toledo's in their midnight blue traveling uniforms, which are trimmed in white and yellow. The Bulls will be moving from left to right here in the opening half. Lead official Glenn Mayborg now into the center circle. With our basketball, we're just about set to get things rolling tonight. And that opening tip-off now is going to be tossed in the air, and it is won by Toledo. The Rockets' Buckley tracks that one down, and now Toledo heads from right to left. Juice Brown at the point, the terrific 5'10 sophomore point guard. Jumps a pass to Booth, open on the right baseline, and he rattles in and out, a 15-footer. McRae, the weak side rebound for the Bulls. Booth was wide open.
Yeah, very
on
good
that right baseline.
Rattled out.
Between the rings, Regan swings it right to Tony Watson. Top of the circle, Skeet, left wing now, McRae. Tries to drive into the hoop on Booth. Spins by him, lays it up the right hand, and hits. Banking it home. 2-0 Buffalo.
Good strong move there from Javon, looking to kind of pound the inside there. I think one of the advantages they have is this Buffalo size in this game.
Brown between the circles, defended by Jaron Skeet, who looks like he has a fresh haircut. Right corner, Smith for a three off the mark. Rebound on the deck. McCray is able to muscle it away from the freshman Booth. Couple of rebounds already for Javon. 2-0 Buffalo. Right wing, Nuerion against the man-to-man. Top of the circle, Regan. Left side, Skeet driving to the baseline. Takes it to the goal, lays it up the left hand, and scores the bucket. 4-0 Buffalo as Skeet took it all the way in.
Great start here for the Bulls. Have struggled a little bit early in games as of late, so to come out and hit their first two shots is a nice start for the Bulls.
Brown misses a runner in the lane for Toledo. Skeet rebounds, takes it back the other way, forces one up off the glass, missed it badly in Booth. Able to grab the carom for Toledo.
Yeah, might have been better off just pulling that out. He kind of rushed that.
Buckley, a pull-up three, swish, just for the left of the circle. Dominic Buckley nailing that three-pointer, his 42nd of the season. Buckley, one of the top three-point marksmen in the MAC. So it's a one-point Buffalo lead. And now Nuerion reached in and fouled by Toledo as he started to drive the right baseline. That foul going against Ryan Pearson. First foul in the odds-on first team All-MAC pick, Ryan Pearson. Buffalo 4, Toledo 3, 18-17 remaining in half number one. And Skeet from the right sideline throws it into Watson out top. Tony top of the circle now, defended by Brown. Throws it to McCray, head of the key. Dribbles a couple of times to his right, hands off to Skeet. Left of the circle, Regan fakes a three. Pitches it back to Skeet. He'll launch a three and hit it. Jaron Skeet has 5 quick points. And it's 7-3 UB.
Nice fake there by Will Regan. Get the defender in the air. The second defender had to close on him. He kicked out to Skeet for the open three.
Buckley bounces to Smith, left of the circle. Texan throws it to Booth, head of the key. Hands off to Pearson. Pearson's first touch. The southpaw tightly guarded by Nuerion. Goes low post to Booth. Hands it back to Pearson. Shoots the baseline jumper. No good off the left side. And McCray, another rebound for UB. 3 boards already for Javon. Bulls by 4. Watson on the left. Pulls up inside the arc. Shoots an 18-footer and cans it. Bulls off to a flying start. Lead at 9-3.
At 4, their first 5 shots of the game. So Reggie Witherspoon's got to be very pleased with the start by his UB squad.
Brown now walking it up the court for Toledo. He averaged 12 points a game last year as a freshman. Bounces it right, almost stolen by Nuerion, who deflected that over the sideline back to Toledo. UB basketball presented by Integrity Office Supply, supplying solutions to your office supply and furniture needs. 9-3 UB, not quite 3 minutes gone in the game. Around a Pearson ball screen, now throws it back to Pearson at the foul line, hands it to Smith in the high post. Entry past the Booth, turnaround shot blocked by McCray. Comes out to Buckley, though, at the free throw line. He backs beyond the arc, triggers a three, no good. Rebound snared by Pearson right of the lane line, and then he runs into Watson, who's called for a block. Very close to being a second foul on Pearson, as Watson got there just a fraction of a second too late. Boy, that would have been a huge second foul on Pearson.
Yeah, without question.
Instead, Pearson now to the line for a pair of free throws. 75% free throw shooter, coming off a 29-point, 14 rebound performance on Saturday.
And here's a guy who's just made a living at the free throw line.
And he hits the first.
He's just tied at his 119th free throw make of the year in 22 games. He made 119 free throws last year in 36, so he's really getting to the line a lot this year.
Toledo, a great foul shooting team, as we talked about earlier. Pearson's second free throw is good. Remember Saturday against Eastern Michigan, he missed 6 of his first 9 free throws, but then Pearson made 10 in a row, made 13 foul shots in the game. Skeet pull-up jumper, left baseline, good. Hit that from about 11 or 12 feet away, and Jaron Skeet's just off to a sensational start tonight.
Yeah, he loves that pull-up jumper, and he's able to drive the baseline and get an open look.
11-5 Buffalo. Deep in the right, Pearson, between the circles for Smith. Swings it left for Brown. Bounces to Pearson, left of the lane. He dribbles it out to the arc, now starts to penetrate on Nuerion. Stumbles, recovers, and scoops it back to Buckley, and they reset it to Brown near midcourt. Shot clock down to 11. Brown skates off toward the right, defended by Skeet. Throws it to Smith, right baseline. Spins on Regan, tries a tough fadeaway. Missed badly, and another rebound for Javon McCray, who rips that out of there. His 4th board. UB with a ball up 6. Nuerion snaps it to Skeet in the right wing. High post right now for McCray, working on Booth. Stuttered steps, takes it down the lane in a foul against Toledo. It's on either Booth or Buckley, who came over to help on defense, and it will be on the freshman Booth, his first. Timeout in the corner of the Alumni Arena. 15:54 to play in half number one. It's Buffalo 11 and Toledo 5. You're listening to Buffalo Bulls basketball here on the UB Basketball Network.
I think they called it on the floor. I don't think he's shooting.
I don't think so. Oh, I don't know.
Reggie's kind of arguing with that. I think they said he was on the
floor. Hey, Mike, everything sound okay? Okay.
Sports fans. He's been a constant in the Buffalo sports lineup, serving 24 years as a sportscaster at WIVB-TV, 14 years as the voice of our Buffalo Bulls football team, and 12 years as a member of the Buffalo Bills radio network. Please welcome Paul Patton. Do you believe it, Bulls fans? We have another special guest with us here tonight. He covered the Buffalo Bills from the Rock Pile to Rich Stadium.
Millard Fillmore Suburban Hospital, a sponsor of UB Hoops. Minimally invasive and robotic surgery available at Millard Fillmore Suburban Hospital. With the Bulls off to a flying start, 5 of 6 from the field. Toledo just 1 for 8. And the Bulls have an 11-5 lead with 15:54 to go here in the first half. Wow, Van Miller's here tonight, huh?
Yeah, it's part of that old school night. They bring back some old Bills and Sabres. Honoring them and the old voice of the Bulls, voice of the Bills, Van Miller, is in the house. Still a Bulls fan. He comes to all the football games and he'll come to occasional basketball games. He's still a big, big popular person here in the city of Buffalo.
They called that foul against Booth on the floor, much to the Bulls' chagrin. They thought McCray should have been going to the line on that foul, but instead Skeet now will trigger it in, throws it toward Watson in the left corner of the pass, tipped. It's stolen by Josh Lemons, who just came in off the Toledo bench. Reese Holiday, who also just came in off the bench, bounces back to Lemons, pass to the left, though, through the hands of Pearson, out of bounds, and it's a turnover on Toledo, their first.
Yeah, I was definitely on Booth there as he kind of points to himself on that one. Just a little pass, a little too high for Pearson to handle.
It's interesting, the first two subs of the game come from Toledo, a team that does not play very many players at all. Skeet penetrating from the left wing all the way to the basket, shot blocked by the freshman Booth. Taken by Brown. Brown streaks up the floor, fires it to Lemon Rice baseline. 15-footer misses wide left. Rebound tipped around to McCray again. Another board for Javon.
It's 5 now for the big guy.
Killing it on the glass. McCray drives in from the top of the key, runs into a man. Offensive foul on McCray as Lemons got there in time to draw that charge. Javon a little bit out of control that time.
That's his first and the team's
second. And now back to Toledo, 15-18 to play in the first, 11-5 Buffalo. Right now it's Lemons, Brown, Holiday, Pearson, and Booth for Toledo. UB still has their starting five out in the court. Pearson down to the right baseline, works against New Area. Top of the key to Booth. Right wing now for Brown, throws a give and go pass to Booth, lays it up in the right and hits.
Yeah, a little bit of a mismatch there as Booth ended up being guarded by Tony Watson. It ended up being an easy layup for Toledo's big guy.
Booth, a high school teammate of the outstanding freshman for Western, Darius Paul. Regan on the left, uses the left hand and gets it to go. An assist from New Area. Got a little pick and roll that time from UB. 13-7 Buffalo. Just over 14 and a half to go in this first half. Pulls off to a nice start, 6 of 8 from the floor. Reese Holiday head of the circle, sixth man for Toledo. He's had some good moments for the Rockets in his career. Like Pearson, he's from the Kansas City area. Now between the circles, Brown pull up three over Skeet, switch. Wow, Skeet was right on him. And Brown launched that one through.
That was impressive.
So it's 13-10 Buffalo. Right wing to Arriuk. Top of the circle, McCray swings it left for Watson. Fakes left, dribbles right. Shoots a three, missed it off the back rim. The rebound caroms off the top of the backboard to Brown for Toledo. Three-pointer would tie it up right now for the Rockets. Into the paint it comes for Boot. Turnaround shot over McCray. Back rim no good. Good defense from McCray that time. Rebound Watson for Buffalo. Skeet fires it ahead to Tony on the left wing. Gets a screen from Regan. Throws it to McCray ahead of the key. Right now for New Area. Gorham to the foul line. Top of the key, Regan. He'll put up a three. In and out. That was halfway down. New Area tips the rebound around, but it's grabbed by Pearson. And then Regan trying to rip it away from Pearson. Wound up fouling the junior for Toledo. First foul on Will. 13-10 Buffalo, 13-39 to play in the first half. Cameron Downing, Corey Rayleigh-Ross, and Xavier Ford all coming in for Buffalo as McCray, New Arianc, and Regan exit. Pearson's going to get a breather right now for Toledo with Dominique Buckley returning. But right now it's Buckley, Lemons running the point. Reese Holiday, Matt Smith back in, and also Richard Wannell, who's coming off the bench, a 6'9 junior, who came to Toledo as a walk-on. 1L, top of the circle, swings it right to Holiday. Takes his dribble down toward the baseline, bounces to Smith, right blocks, turns on Ford and drops it through the hoop as he leaps up toward the basket. And it's a one-point game now, 13-12 UB. Watson started to penetrate, whipped it to Ford on the left, hands off to Rayleigh Ross. The reverse it back to Downing, top of the arc. Back over to Corey on the left wing. Corey whips a bounce pass to Downing. Low post left. He turns, lost the ball going up against 1L. And the loose ball tracked down, though, by Watson way out near midcourt. Shot clock down to 13. Bulls by a point. Skeet on a dribble. Pitches it back to Watson on the right. He'll launch a three. A little bit short. And 1L, the rebound for Toledo right under the hoop.
Yeah, well, Tony got a great look in the corner there as the defender stayed with Jaron, but he just couldn't get the shot to go in.
Now Smith a three right of the circle, off the mark. Tony Watson boards it for Buffalo. Skeet down the center of the court on the dribble. Spots up Watson on the left. Fakes a shot. Dribbles to the basket. Throws one off the backboard. No good, but a foul. Matt Smith called for the blocking foul. First on the Toledo forward. And Tony Watson goes to the free throw line now for UB.
It's interesting to watch Buffalo here really picking the tempo up. They haven't been doing that all year, kind of slowing it down. But it seems like they're really trying to get out to run. I think it's just because Toledo plays, you know, 6-7 guys. And I think they're really trying to, you know, utilize their energy and try to wear out the Rockets.
Watson's first free throw is good. 3 points for Tony Watson, who's shooting 88% at the free throw line. He's now 22 of 25 in the season. One more now for the lefty, who scored 14 points against Northern on Saturday. And that's a round and in. Watson makes them both back to a 3-point lead now for the Bulls. Watson's going to pick up Buckley as he lightly jogs it up the court from right to left for Toledo. Buckley takes it to the right wing, hands off to Holiday, now up front for Lemons. Lemons dribbles to the right. Downing guards him momentarily in a switch. Long bounce pass underneath for Smith. Shot blocked from behind by Xavier Ford, who came out of nowhere to block that shot. UB ball now. Watson, head of the circle. Snaps it right to Ford, right baseline Rayleigh Ross. He starts toward the bucket, hangs in the air, missed a little runner. Rebound snared by Holiday for Toledo. Now the Rockets will push it. Lemons bounces to 1L on the left. He lays it up and in. 1L scoring in transition. Just his 12th and 13th points of the season. And the Buffalo lead trimmed again to 1 point, 15-14. Skeet drives in from the wing. Cut off by Lemons. Fans it back out. Throws it top of the key, Rayleigh Ross. Right wing to Watson. To Ford, head of the circle. Hands off left to Skeet. Now Downing head of the key. Right wing Watson. Tony screen and roll down to Downing. Cutting in from the right. He lays it up and home. Nicely executed by the Bulls.
Yeah, I think they need to go back. They've been kind of settling for threes lately, but the pick and roll has really been working for the Bulls. I think they have to stick with it.
17-14. The Bulls are up by three. Got a timeout coming up. Next dead ball. Lemons out of Cincinnati. Pans the dribble. Stops top of the key. Throws a left wing Buckley. He'll put up a three to tie it. It rattles in and out. And the rebound out of bounds off Holiday for Toledo. All right, a timeout on the floor in Amherst. 11:07 left here in the first half. It's Buffalo 17, Toledo 14. And you're listening to Buffalo Bulls basketball here on the UB Basketball Network.
Catering logo. All right, how do they know? is coming to a stop. All right, what do you think? A, B, or C? Beth, which one do you think it is?
C.
All right, she's going with C. Let's take a look. And it is C. Congratulations. But a pan pizza compliments it. There's a great campus dining and shops for your entire row. Congratulations. Okay, fans, grab your phones and direct your attention to the video board for the Verizon Wireless Twitter trivia question of the game. It's old school night here at Alumni Arena.
Wow.
Who is the oldest player on the Bulls roster? Tweet your answer, name and seat location at UB Game Day. One lucky fan who tweets the correct answer with a Bulls winter hat will announce the winner in the second half.
Karuba Collision sponsors UB Hoops. Make the right decision. Insist on Karuba Collision. Bulls have led wire to wire so far. And Toledo's just 5 for 17 from the field. Bulls ahead 17-14. 11:07 remaining in the first half. Bulls ball out of the timeout. Watson right now running the point with Ford, Nwariunk, Downing, and Raley Ross also on the court. Downing head of the circle swings it right for Raley Ross. Toledo shifting into his own defense. Watson on the left beyond three. Left wing for Nwariunk. Guns it into the low post for 40. Lost it on a power dribble. Taken out of the scrum there by Brown for Toledo as the Bulls turn it over for the third time. Brown into the lane. Tries a tough floater. No good, but Booth tipped it in. An air ball that kind of was floating under the rim. And Booth with an acrobatic tip in right below the basket.
The hand kind of came out of nowhere and just tipped it right in. Nice play by Booth.
17-16. Bulls by a point. Toledo staying in the zone. Raley Ross left side tries a three air ball. And a weak side rebound for Brown, the point guard. He penetrates down the floor, pitches it right for Buckley, open for a three. No good short. Rebound launched out of bounds on the left side by Booth, who tried to slap that to a teammate. And so the Bulls have it from left to right. John McCray will check in now for Buffalo. So will Regan. And Xavier Ford and Cameron Downing come out. The Bulls have not trailed at all tonight. They're up by one right now, just over the midway point of here of our first half. Bulls playing a West Division opponent for the final time this season. They're 3-2 against the West so far this year. Watson in the right corner. Starts down the baseline, shovels it to McCray, forces it up on the right, dances off the rim, no good. Smith the rebound. Had Pearson going the other way on an outlet pass, but couldn't find him. Well, Toledo now trying to take their first lead. Brown between the circles. Here comes a lob for Smith. Makes the catch too far under the hoop. Bounces to Booth left of the lane. Tries a 16-footer and hits it. Booth now with a half a dozen, and it's 18-17. Toledo with their first lead. 9.5 minutes to play before the break. Nwariunk at the left hash mark. No look. Bounce pass to Regan left mid post. Takes it into the paint. Righty hook shot. Bounces in off the front of the rim. Good looking hook shot there from Will Regan.
Yeah, he definitely has that in his repertoire. It's good to see him working around the basket. I think sometimes he settles a little too much, kind of falls in love with that three-point shot. But he can definitely play around the basket. It's good to see that he's doing that tonight.
And now the Bulls are ahead by a point. Buckley on the right. Dribbles at the top of the key. Feeds it over to Brown on the left. Bounce pass down to Pearson. Drives down the baseline. Pull-up shot just outside the lane. No good. Weak side rebound to Tony Watson for Buffalo. Pearson yet to connect on a field goal.
I think a lot of it has to do with the great defense, but Orem Nwariunk is playing on it tonight.
Raley Ross way out high, throws it to Orem out on the left. Left sideline to Tony Watson, lobs it to McCray between the circles. And right wing now for Raley Ross. Here's Regan between the key. Left hand to Nwariunk, underneath for Regan, fires it back out top to Watson. And Tony threw it away, threw it behind Raley Ross, who had peeled off toward the bucket, and it went out of bounds to Toledo.
And that's just one of those unforced turnovers that the Bulls just have to avoid. You know, they obviously have been struggling with turnovers all year, but a lot of them have just been unforced like that, and they really have to cut back on that to be successful.
Hey, Tony Watson's getting a breather here. First one we've seen him get in a handful of games.
That's right.
He comes out. Jaren Skeet replaces him. Brown at the left wing, lobs it toward Booth, left of the lane. He backs in now to the lane on McRae, righty hook shot over Javon. Short, and Skeet all alone for the rebound under the hoop for Buffalo. Bulls by one, 19-18, with the ball, shooting to Goldor right. Noriank on the right wing, throws it to Regan, head of the circle, fakes a three, drives to the free throw line, then hands it back to Noriank. He probes the left side of the lane, but it's stolen by Pearson. Flips it ahead to Brown, who has Regan to beat. Right side layup is good for Juice Brown. And Toledo has a 20-19 edge. Rayleigh Ross at the right wing for Buffalo. Wants to go to McRae, who's posting up Booth. Doesn't get it to him. Outside left to Nueriak. Headed the key for McRae. Right wing now to Corey. Corey does bounce it down to McRae now. Peels toward the paint, and he's bumped from behind by Nathan Booth. And that's the second foul on that freshman, Nathan Booth, for Toledo. Timeout courtside here in Amherst. Still 7:43 of play in our opening half. And what has turned out to be a tight one right now is in favor of Toledo. The Rockets 20 and the Bulls 19. You're listening to Buffalo Bulls basketball on the UB Basketball Network. My phone just buzzed.
I don't know.
Are you ready? First slide, here we go. All right, and all right, just a little bit right. Straighten it out, not bad. Second ball.
Should respond.
Ooh, all right. Just a little bit more distance. I think you have to range.
Like that. Yeah.
Third ball through. And anyway, it's going to roll well.
Too soon. I gotta wait to respond to that. You know, yeah. Yeah.
No rush.
No.
16 and 17. Download your 2013 registration and team roster at BuffaloMasters.com. Entry forms must be submitted by February 25th.
I don't know where she works. Shady.
Yeah.
Well. At Dunn Tire, every tire is out the door with the guaranteed lowest price and complete installation, including the Dunn Dozen. Dunn Tire, service you deserve and professionals you trust. 20-19 Toledo, 7:43 to go in the first half. Josh Wetzel and John Fuller with you from Alumni Arena. Bulls basketball after that last foul on Nathan Booth. Booth is out. Richard Winnell has returned to play the low post for Toledo. Rayleigh Ross takes the inbound pass to the right baseline. They reverse it around to the left now for Nueriak. Left wing for Skeet. Whips a bounce pass to McRae. Left low blocks. Spins into the lane. Right-hand shot near the rim. No good. Rebound. Volleyball around. And finally an offensive board for the Bulls. Aram Nueriak has it.
Their first offensive board of the game. It's their 14th rebound of the game, just the first on the offensive side. And I know Reggie was really harping on that before the game. He wanted to make sure we got a lot of offensive rebounds.
Regan right wing. Throws it to McRae at the high post. Shoots a 17-footer. Swish! Devon McRae really just inside the top of the key hit that one to give the Bulls a 21-20 edge.
Yeah, you don't see that very often, but it's good when he starts hitting that shot because it's going to make the defense come out and guard him out there. And then, you know, he can drive past his defender and go to the basket.
Out top, Juice Brown for Toledo. Dribbles to the right, throws it to Reese Holiday ahead of the key, fakes a pass, drives to the basket, scoops up the right hand, and he gets the roll. Reese Holiday's first points. He was held scoreless in only 11 minutes against Eastern Michigan on Saturday. Toledo ahead, 22-21. Outside left, McRae over to Rayleigh Ross on the left. Takes it toward the goal, bounces right baseline. Skeet, kick out to Nueriak. He shoots a three and hits.
There's the ball movement they've been talking about. They're going to keep the ball moving around. Nice baseline drive by Rayleigh Ross to Skeet in the corner. Instead of taking that shot, he makes one more pass. And Orem's wide open and drained the three.
Bulls up 24-22. Lemons right corner, bounces to Pearson in the right blocks, takes it in the lane on Nueriak. Wild left-handed shot, dances off, no good. Tipped up by Winnell, won't go. And McCray, a rebound for Buffalo, is sixth already. UB with 6 minutes to go has the ball and a two-point lead. Regan outside left, left sideline for Nueriak. Throws it to Regan, little pick and roll down on the blocks. He's cut off. Throws it back to Orem in the left corner. Orem dribbles out to the wing. Needs some help now after killing the dribble. Feeds it top of the key to McCray, and they reset it to Skeet at the point. Shot clock down to 11. Skeet dribbles around at Regan, pick, takes it to the basket, throws it off the glass, hits the bank shot, and he's fouled.
Wow.
Skeet knocked to the floor, was able to fire that in off the glass anyway. The foul is against Winnell for Toledo. A really terrific shot by Skeet, who now goes to the line for the and one.
Yeah, I mean, he was a very acrobatic move by Skeet. Good aggressive move to the basket, gets the and one. He's showing a lot of energy tonight. He already has 9 points here, and we're not even to halftime.
And a free throw coming up. Lemons is leaving now for Toledo, and Buckley leaves the game. Corey Rayleigh Ross giving the Bulls some good minutes off the bench. Now comes out for UB, replaced by Tony Watson. Skeet looking for the Bulls' 27th point of the game. Puts up the free throw, and it's off the back iron, no good. Rebound to Holiday for Toledo, and then his outlet pass got stolen by Skeet, but he touched the right sideline. And so Toledo does still have it. 26-22 Bulls. 5 minutes, 38 seconds of play here in the first.
Yeah, good hustle there by Skeet. Just stepped on the line, wasn't able to save the ball, but good hustle. Putting his head down after missing that free throw and keeping his head up on defense.
That Skeet drive to the bucket, by the way, will be our drive of the game, brought to you by Castle Products. We're not just American-made, we're your neighbor. Brown at the foul line, fades away over Skeet. Missed it just inside the arc. Orem Nueriak clears the rebound for Buffalo. Skeet angles his dribble down to the left wing. Pulls up near the corner. Lobs it to McCray, left short corner. He fires it over to Orem on the right. He'll trigger a three. Back rim no good. And Pearson rips down the rebound for Toledo. And then he throws it away to the right side. One else saves it, but it tipped into the backcourt by Skeet. He dives on top of it, but rolls onto the baseline. Great hustle by Skeet. But it will be Toledo basketball. And the fans here recognizing the tremendous hustle from the UB freshman.
Almost got it.
Knocked that ball away near midcourt, and it just started rolling toward the baseline, and Jaron went diving after it.
Just slid over the baseline there, but good hustle by the freshman point guard.
Toledo moving it right to left, down by four, under 5 minutes to play in the half. Reese Holiday out front, between the circles to Brown. Now right elbow Pearson. Pearson having a tough time offensively against Orem Nueriak. Drives down the right side of the lane, puts up that lefty off the glass, no good, and a foul. We'll get Ryan Pearson to the line. Kevin O'Connell whistled this one against Nueriak. That will be Orem's first foul. And now Pearson to the line for the second time tonight. His only 2 points coming from the free throw line. Pearson's 0 for 3 right now from the floor. That was a second team All-MAC pick a year ago. Probably should have been a first teamer. Averaged 16.5 points a game, over 8 rebounds a game. Reggie Witherspoon wanted to know if that should have been a shove on Pearson to try and clear some room against Orem. As Pearson now hits the free throw. I mean, Pearson's one of these guys that has a big bag of tricks that he uses to score his points. I think the Bulls coaching staff might have a point there. It looked like Pearson with a little subtle arm bar to try and get himself some room. But the whistle went against Nueriak. One more for the southpaw, Ryan Pearson. Older brother Roderick played collegiately at Oral Roberts in Tulsa. That's in and out. Pearson with a miss. Nueriak rebounds for Buffalo, his third board. Bulls right now up three as Toledo has shifted back into that zone defense with Pearson right up at the top of it. Kind of a 1-2-2 zone. Regan entry pass from Rayleigh Ross. It's tipped away, and it goes over the sideline to Toledo. Bulls turn it over for the sixth time. And now Toledo will have a shot at tying this thing up if they would hit a trifecta. Both teams are 2-for-7 right now from three-point range. Toledo overall shooting just 33%. Well, the Bulls are at 52%. Holiday between the circles, throws it right to Buckley. Buckley back to Holiday between the rings. He'll step into a three over Regan. Off the mark wide right, and an aggressive rebound to Javon McCray for the Bulls, who has 7 first half rebounds. We'll still 4 minutes to go before we take a break. Watson left side, hooks a bounce pass down to Regan, left short corner. Backs in on 1L, hook shot in the paint over 1L, no good. And Holiday covers up the rebound for the Rockets. They're down by three. Lemons between the circles, dribbles around a pick from Holiday, throws it left to Buckley, jumps a pass to Holiday right of the circle. Holiday still in the dribble beyond three. They reset it to Buckley out top. Buckley throws it to Holiday on the right. Holiday now dribbling against the taller Regan, takes it into the paint, spins on him, lost control, fell down, got the ball back, and the ball went out of bounds to Toledo, I guess.
Yeah, it looked like he landed on the baseline there.
Yeah, very curious. Well, we were kind of blocked off trying
to
see what happened. It's going to be Toledo basketball after the timeout. 3:28 to go before we hit halftime. Buffalo 26, Toledo 23. And this is Buffalo Bulls basketball on the UB Basketball Network.
Okay, so you're supposed to be in that class with Mark Adler, who's over in section 110. That's the class. I guess over there. All right, well, Claire, you can win a $25 gift card to UB Bookstore by answering the following old school trivia question. Which of the following is not a member? Is it A?
I think it's C. Isn't it?
Don't act like you don't know the answer.
I think it's C.
It is C, and you know it.
I don't know it for sure. I wouldn't bet my life on it.
You have won a $25 gift card to the UB Bookstore for the greatest selection of UB merchandise shop at the University Bookstore. Congratulations. Enjoy the rest of the class. All right, and now it is time for the Time Warner Cable Kids Dance Contest. All the young Bulls fans out there, show us your moves. Who will be the winner of the Time Warner Cable T-shirt? Looking good so far. All right, who's next?
Here's an. This is not on the stats tonight, I noticed.
I'll have to add that somewhere.
Yeah.
It kind of gets cut off. Maybe it's on the next page.
Can you customize that?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
What? UB Athletics would like to thank Dunn Tire, AT&T Mobility, Campus Living, and the Catholic Health System for their contributions to the Community Partners Program, providing tickets to charitable organizations across Western New York. Buffalo 26, Toledo 23. 3:28 to go before halftime, and it is Toledo ball at their offensive end. 12 seconds to shoot. Juice Brown is going to inbound it right of the hoop for the Rockets. The 5'10 point guard flips it into Holiday, forces one up right of the glass, no good. Weak side rebound to Nuoriunk for Buffalo. Bulls out rebounding Toledo, 19-14. Tony Watson right now running the point, throws it to Rayleigh Ross outside left. Pearson loosely defending him in that man-to-man. Long bounce pass deflected away from McCray back to Watson. Now to Nuoriunk between the rings. Orem bounces it toward Regan. It's poked away again. Will recovers the right baseline. Gives it back to Orem to the high post. He's cut off in the paint. Has to force up a tough shot. No. McCray, though, bats it in off the backboard. 28-23 Bulls. Pearson pull-up jumper left of the lane, and it's around the rim twice. No good as it spins free to McCray.
That's Javon's ninth rebound already with 2:45 to go in the first half.
The Bulls are ahead by five. Nuoriunk outside right. Kills the dribble, needs some help. Fires it down low to McCray in the blocks. Spins by Smith, lays it up with the right hand and scores. Eight points for McCray.
That's what the Bulls really need to do. Right now, Toledo's a very small team on the floor right now. I think we're going to get a steady dose of Javon McCray here for the rest of the half.
And all of a sudden, a seven-point lead for UB, their biggest lead of the night. 30-23 Buffalo. Smith from the right elbow drives on the crate of the basket. Missed a runner off the glass, no. Rebound to Pearson, though, under the hoop. He lost the ball, though, and it went out of bounds off of Pearson. And it will be UB basketball. Pearson couldn't hang on after getting that ball right in the lane. Jaron Skeet comes back in for Buffalo, John, replacing Corey Rayleigh Ross.
Yeah, I think Corey gave him some good minutes there. They're a little shorthanded. Usually Rafael Thomas Edwards might get those minutes, but he's out with the hamstring injury. And, you know, Corey, you know, he's had some ups and downs. Obviously, he started some games earlier in the year. They kind of found himself buried on the bench. But he's working his way back and getting some positive energy. As long as he works hard, you know, he's going to keep playing.
Regan inside the left elbow, back to the hoop. Put it on the floor, almost lost it to Pearson. Bounces, though, to Nuoriunk, low left. He got rid of it in the paint to McCray. Puts it up with the left hand and banked it in. 10 points now for McCray. And a timeout called by Toledo with the Bulls leading 32-23 with a minute 50 to go in the half. Keep it here in this timeout. Bulls all of a sudden up by 9 points, and Todd Kowalczyk, the head coach for Toledo, was not happy after that McCray bucket.
Well, if I'm not mistaken, I believe that's six straight points by Javon there. So he's really, he kind of started out slow, at least offensively, because he got the rebounds, but now they're just working the ball down to him, and like they have a little bit small, with Booth being out of the lineup right now, they're a lot smaller of a team, and I think Javon's able to take advantage of that.
Bulls were down 22-21 with about 7 minutes to go in the half. They're on an 11-1 run since. McCray, 10 points, 9 rebounds. Kind of a quiet 10 points, too, for Javon. He's really been efficient, hitting 5 of 7 shots. Right now it's Smith, Brown, Holiday, Buckley, and Pearson for Toledo. The Bulls with Skeet, Nuerionk, Regan, Watson, and McCray. Brown deep on the right side, watched by Skeet and the UB man-to-man. Now out comes McCray in a double team. Flips it over to Smith, driving right baseline. He's cut off by Regan. They reset to Brown way out top. Brown dribbling between the circles, calls out the set. 13 to shoot as Brown starts off to the right. Now drives to the left, gets into the lane, stops in the blocks. Tries a tough fadeaway, missed it. Well defended down low. Rebound Buffalo. Skeet lobbed at Watson left side. Timeout Buffalo.
I think Will Regan might have gotten a piece of that. And a piece of that last shot. Skeet was able to swoop in for the rebound. Bulls grab a timeout here, try to work on a player at the end of the half. But I'm really impressed with UB's defense right now. Especially Orem Nwerioyunk. I mean, you have a kid in Ryan Pearson who's come in averaging 18 points a game. Ryan Pearson in the last game against Eastern Michigan, arguably the best defensive team in the MAC, put up 28 points and 14 rebounds. So you know he's a very good player, and Orem's done a great job of clamping down on him on defense, as the whole team has. But defensively, this is by far the Bulls' best effort in a number of games.
Yeah, Pearson has not made a bucket, 0 for 4. And Toledo shot 35% against Eastern on Saturday. That was the worst they had shot in a MAC game all year. They're at only 28% right now, 9 of 32. Bulls by 9 with the ball, a minute 16 to play in the half. Watson will inbound it far side across from the Toledo bench. And it comes to McCray, back to Tony, left corner for 3, bullseye!
Great set play there, brought in to Javon. Tony inbounded, kind of snuck to the corner, got behind the defense, hit the open 3. Just what the Bulls needed.
9-0 Buffalo run has them ahead by a dozen. A minute to play in the half, 35-23. Smith right short corner, takes it into the paint on Regan. Turnaround shot blocked by Will Partially. Grabbed though by Bonnell. Kick out Buckley, he'll fire up a 3, no good. McCray the rebound is 10th. A double-double in the first half for Javon McCray. 10 points, 10 rebounds.
And I'm glad I didn't jinx Javon. I'd put in the notes this week that he's one of two players in the MAC to have scored in double figures in every MAC game.
Orem now tries a 3 right of the circle off the mark. Rebound along the baseline to Ryan Pearson.
So I'm glad I didn't jinx him. I was a little worried as he got off to a little bit slow start. I was anxiously looking at the box score. So shot. I'm off the hook.
You're off the hook. Shot clock is off. Toledo going to play for the last shot of the half. Down a dozen. 12 seconds now to go. Brown deep on the left. Gets a screen from Winnell. Dribbles around it to the top of the key. Now probes the right side of the lane. Finds Pearson in the right corner. Shoots a guarded jumper. Short. Winnell the rebound. Follows and scores right before the buzzer. Winnell able to make it a 10-point game at halftime. Buffalo 35, Toledo 25. But you're right, John. A great defensive effort from the Bulls here in the first half, and they have a 10-point lead over a Rockets team that's reeled off 5 straight wins.
Yeah, as good as that half went, I know it's going to, Reggie's going to go into that locker room, a little upset with the way that the Rockets were able to get that offensive rebound and put back at the end of the half. It's the one area the Bulls need to clean up a little bit. As well as they're rebounding, the Rockets now have, I believe, 5 offensive rebounds and a 6-second chance point. So that's one area that they're going to have to clean up here in the second half to be successful.
So a 10-point edge for Buffalo at the break, 35-25 over Toledo. Time for a break. We'll return with our halftime coverage from Alumni Arena after this. You're listening to Buffalo Bulls Basketball on the UB Basketball Network. Yeah, I'm good, yeah. Thank you. Whoops.
First in the Black Helmets,
we have Kishara and Kenneth, and they are playing for section 120, and Alex and Mike in the blue helmets are playing for section 102.
I can't believe you went over 5.
Is wearing a bun, as you can see, and they have their topics.
That guy, that guy.
Square hamburger, the bacon cheese people, lettuce and tomato. The team that builds the Wendy's burger the fastest will win your Wendy's coupon for their entire section. All right, blue team, are you ready? Black team, are you ready? Honey Mark, get set, go. All right, we are underway here. And the bottom half of the bun is taking the patty, and they are down and off they go. All right, it is bacon first for the blue team and bacon. As well, pickles in for blue. Black going for tomato. Blue with the tomato. All right. Next up for blue is the lettuce. Followed by pickles for the black. And this looks like it's going to be his. And oh man, big splash for the blue team and section 102. Congratulations, senior seats. Our promotions team will deliver your coupon. Fans, it is now time to give away some money. Inside the 7Q money machine, there is $1,000. And our contestant, Carrie, has 30 seconds to grab as much money as she can while it's flying around inside the 7Q money machine. And the best part is she gets to keep whatever she can hold on to. All right, looks like we are all set, ready to go. 30 seconds on the clock. On your mark, get set, go. All right, we are underway here. Scooping up tons of cash, putting it into the jacket. That is the best move of all. All right, we are 10 seconds in at this point. All right, Carrie is doing very well.
Well, the Bulls with a very good first half defensively, limiting Toledo to 28% shooting. The Bulls hit almost 54% and a 35-25 lead now for UB. UB led the vast majority of the first 10 to 11 minutes of this half. Toledo took their first lead with about 8 minutes to go in the first half, going up 18-17. They led 20-19. In fact, they're in the middle portion of the half. There were six different lead changes. Bulls were trailing 22-21 when they would go on a little 5-0 run, going up 26-22. Ryan Pearson then made one of two free throws to make it 26-23. Bulls, though, followed with a 9-0 run after that. Javon McCray doing a bunch of that damage. Also a three-point hit from Tony Watson after a timeout to put the Bulls up as much as a dozen. And then Toledo with a final possession of the half had Ryan Pearson miss a baseline jumper, but Richard Winnell able to grab an offensive rebound at follow and score right before the buzzer, giving us this 10-point spread at halftime, 35-25. So the Bulls trying to win for the second straight time after knocking off Northern Illinois on Saturday, trying to halt Toledo's five-game win streak. And at the break at home, the Bulls are leading by 10 points. We'll take a break. We'll return to take a closer look at the halftime statistics presented by ComDoc right after this. You're listening to Buffalo Bulls Basketball on the UB Basketball Network. Whoa.
They're really good.
Correct answers win a Bulls travel mug. All right, now fans, don't be afraid to help the contestants by shouting out your answers. All right, contestants, are you ready? All right, let's take a look at the video board here. If you know that clip, go ahead and ring the bell. Congratulations.
Yes, yes, you've got the white 5-0. All right, Regina, come on, here we go. We're going to get the next one. All right, you ready? Next one.
Hey, man, you're
a great. Tiffany Tisabel, Austin Spacey is correct. All right, Regina, let's get our hand right over there.
Regina, get ready to go. Here we go.
Next one.
Do you own a TV, Regina?
Running away here. All right, clip number six.
Oh, man. Ashley's running. Ashley's running. Now, I saw Reggie actually went for the bell, but we're still watching the TV and totally missed the bell. All right, last clip. Here we go.
There's a man. Okay. I'm sorry.
Yeah, good to see you.
Twilight.
Yes, very good. All right, we got one there. This one though, and I think it is Jim. All right, Jim, you are the winner. Congratulations, you won the Bulls travel mug. Bob Kuczynski, thank you very much for being
thank
here.
Thank you. Watch WBBC TV and Sports Wrap-Up.
Halftime stats brought to you as always by ComDoc. Bulls ahead 35-25 over a Toledo team that came into tonight tied for first in the MAC West with Western Michigan. Toledo on the season shooting 43% from the field tonight. They've been held to 28% though in the first half, 10 for 36. They go 2 for 9 from 3, 3 out of 4 from the foul line. The Bulls are shooting 54%, 15 of 28. That includes a 3 4 for 9 job from 3-point land. And the Bulls are 2 for 3 from the free throw line. The Bulls have out-rebounded Toledo 24-17, although Toledo has 5 offensive boards. The Bulls have only 2. 8 assists, 6 turnovers for Buffalo. 5 assists, only 1 turnover for Toledo. In terms of scoring, boy, already a double-double for Javon McCray. 10 points, 10 rebounds. The 8th double-double of the year for Javon, who had 7 double-doubles last year. He's added 2 assists and a block tonight. 9 points for Jaron Skeet to go along with 4 rebounds. 7 points, 3 boards, and assists for Tony Watson. 4 points, a couple of assists, a couple of blocks for Will Regan. 3 points, 4 rebounds, 2 assists for Orem Nueriuk, who's done an outstanding job defensively on Ryan Pearson. And Cameron Downing has 2 points as well for UB. Meanwhile, for Toledo, they have been led in the first half by freshman Nathan Booth, who scored 6 points, though he did so in only 10 minutes because of picking up a couple of fouls. He's the only guy in the game with 2 fouls. 5 points for Juice Brown. 4 points for Richard Winnell off the bench. 3 points for Ryan Pearson, who averages over 18 a game. Those 3 points come in on 3 out of 4 free throws. And Pearson has gone 0 for 5 from the field. He does have 4 rebounds. 3 points for Dominique Buckley. And 2 points for Reese Holiday and Matt Smith. Bulls lead 35-25 after 20 minutes. Those halftime statistics brought to you by ComDoc. Visit comdoc.com to request a free print responsibility assessment. Aid donations to the Blue and White Fund support every UB student athlete from every UB team. Join the many alumni and friends who've committed to help the UB teams compete for MAC championships. Make a gift today. Give UB a call at 645-6867 or log on to buffalobulls.com to see how you can help the Blue and White Fund. Bulls up by 10 over Toledo after the first 20 minutes. It's a 35-25 score. And we'll return with out-of-town scores from around the MAC. And we'll get that second half started right after this break. You're listening to Buffalo Bulls Basketball on the UB Basketball Network. Yeah.
I can't believe you're not going on this trip.
Maybe I'll surprise you and just show up Friday night.
Yeah.
What if I'm at that bar? Sit there at that bar and just walk in.
Be like, and I just walk up, not reacting very much, be like, I didn't think I was ever going to see you again.
A single tear would fall.
Yeah, right.
Fans, please welcome back to the court your UB Bulls. Fans, direct your attention to the video board for some out-of-town scores brought to you by Pearl Street Grill and Brewery. The Pearl Street Grill and Brewery, always changing, always upgrading, helps you what's new, including Brawler's Deli.
35-25, Buffalo leading Toledo here in Amherst tonight. Time to take a look at those out-of-town scores brought to you by the DoubleTree Hotel by Hart Hotels. Quite a few close games around the MAC right now. Ohio trying to improve to 9-1, leading by only 4 at Central Michigan at halftime, 35-31. Akron right now by only 3 at Eastern Michigan at the half. The Zips 29, the Eagles 26, Akron 10-0, the first MAC team to start a conference season 10-0 since Miami in the 1983-1984 season. Akron with the longest current win streak in the country. They've won 15 straight games. Tied up game at Bowling Green tonight. Western Michigan and Bowling Green are 30-30 at the half. And the only game that's really a complete blowout at the half is at Kent State, where the Golden Flashes are leading the Bulls' next opponent, Miami, 48-32. Ball State playing on the road at Northern Illinois in a game that is getting ready to tip off at any moment. Big Four action, LaSalle leading St. Bonaventure and Olean after 20 minutes, 38-27. And in top 25 play, top-ranked Indiana has a 27-18 lead at halftime over Nebraska. Third-ranked Miami leading at Florida State, 38-30 at the break. Sixth-ranked Syracuse trailing at UConn, 29-24 at halftime. 11th-ranked Butler trailing home to Charlotte at the break, 29-27. Number 17, Oklahoma State with a 55-34 lead in Lubbock over Texas Tech at half. And number 21, Notre Dame, 43-32 at halftime in South Bend. Those out-of-town scores are brought to you by the DoubleTree Hotel by Hart Hotels. Before or after the game, visit the DoubleTree by Hilton, Buffalo, Amherst. We are right next door. All right, Josh Wetzel back with you along with John Fuller, Mike Klein in the studios. And at halftime, the Bulls are ahead here, 35-25 over Toledo. And, John, if you're the Bulls, you really just want to keep doing what you've been doing, with the exception of maybe keeping Toledo off that offensive glass a little bit better.
Yeah, I mean, the Bulls are obviously, they're up 24-17 in the rebounding edge, but the Bulls only have 2 offensive rebounds, while Toledo has 5 offensive rebounds that led to 6 second chance points, including that shot there at the end of the half. But I think, like I said, that was probably their best defensive half of the season by far. To be able to keep Pearson quiet with only 3 points all at the free throw line is a very nice accomplishment, and hopefully they keep that going here in the second half. You know Pearson's going to want to start getting his points, so we'll see how it transpires.
Yeah, this is a Toledo team with some very good offensive weapons, and the Bulls held them to 28% shooting in the first half.
Yeah, and conversely, on the offensive end, the Bulls shoot 54% from the field, but nice mix of inside-outside. I think, they started off strong by going to the basket a lot. Then they kind of fell in love with a three-pointer and wasn't going down. Then they got back into what they were, their bread and butter, so to say, tonight with going to the basket and scoring inside. They've scored 18 of their 35 points have come in the paint, so I think they need to keep going with that, especially if Booth continues to stay in foul trouble. When he was on the bench, they were a completely different team, so obviously he's a big guy who can wreak some havoc in there.
Both teams have their starting lineups on the court right now. The Bulls will have the ball first in the second half with Skeet, Watson, Nwariunk, McCray, and Regan on the court, and for Toledo, it's Brown, Buckley, Booth, Pearson, and Smith. UB from right to left, Skeet on the dribble to the right wing, stops beyond the arc, flips it to McCray right of the lane, spins toward the baseline, puts one up over Booth, missed it, Pearson Pulls away the weak side rebound for Toledo. He dribbles it up the court himself. Pearson, a lefty, has it now on the right wing. Bounces out to Brown between the circles. Over to Buckley now, left wing. The former Iowa State player throws it down low to Booth. Kick out Smith, left wing. Regan closes on him, preventing the three. Down low to Booth, backing in on Regan. Tries a tough turnaround. Should say backing down to McCray, and then Javon got a piece of that turnaround shot. Second block of the night for McCray. Bulls basketball leading by 10 here as we get that second half started. Noriank left wing, now drives on the lane, scoops it up with the right hand. Nice. Hits the layup as he went across the lane from left to right.
A strong move by Orem there, and he took a lot of contact. I'm surprised they didn't call a foul, but they let the play go, but he still got the two.
He drove it right through the traffic, and gives the Bulls a dozen-point advantage, 37-25. A minute gone by in the second half. Deep right, Pearson pulls up right of the lane, 15-footer over McCray, no good. Nwariank the rebound, and Pearson is 0-for-6 now from the floor. This guy scored 26 points against the Bulls a year ago in Toledo. Right sideline, Watson. Top of the key, McCray drives right down the center of the lane. Booth slapped it away. Javon got it back, missed the layup. Rebounded to his own miss, puts it up and in.
Yeah, I think he's just trying to pat his own stats now. Kind of missed that bunny layup. Was able to get the rebound and layup back in. 12 rebounds now for Javon.
The Bulls have their biggest lead of the game, 39-25. And Todd Kowalczyk, the Toledo head coach, just standing with his hands on his hips there in front of the Rockets bench. He does not look pleased. Shaking his head right now as he watches their offense. Brown right wing puts up a guarded rainbow three, leaves it short over Skeet. And McCray rebounds it down along the baseline. 13th board for Javon. That ties his career high. We've got 18 minutes to go in this game. Nwariank right wing around a McCray pick. Throws it to Regan, top of the circle, fakes a shot, drives the lane, puts it up with a left hand, missed the layup, but he drew a foul.
Nice move there by Will. We saw that last game against Northern Illinois where he faked the three and drove it right down there for a dunk. Doing the same thing there. He's such a good three-point shooter, and he loves that spot at the top of the key. The defender always has to come out and guard him. That time he just faked it and ran right past him and was able to draw the foul.
And a key third foul on Nathan Booth. He's the first man in the game but three fouls. Regan leaves the free throw short. Booth has maybe played better than anybody when he's been on the floor for Toledo tonight. And right now, Todd Kowalczyk leaving Booth on the floor with three fouls. Regan hits the second foul shot for his fifth point of the game. Bulls the only team to score so far in the second half. 40-25, Buffalo. Brown along the arc right side. Top of the circle, Buckley takes it to the left on Watson. Spins out to the left wing. Snaps it over to Pearson outside right. Dribbles at the top of the key, lobs it to Buckley near the left corner. Drives baseline, puts up a teardrop, missed it. Pearson, though, tips it in. First field goal of the game for Ryan Pearson. First points of the second half for Toledo.
Yeah, stuck in there and got the offensive tip. They both have got to do a better job of boxing out there.
Buffalo 40, Toledo 27. Regan head of the circle, swings it left for Nwariank. Top of the key to McCray, works it around to the right for Watson. Top of the arc, Regan. Thought about a three, instead pitches it left to Nwariank. Hands it back to Skeet, deep left. Top of the key, McCray reverses it to Watson, right wing. Top of the key, Regan. He'll shoot this three-pointer. Miss it off the back rim. Long rebound, Buckley at the foul line for Toledo. Slips it ahead to Pearson, angling in from the left. Tough fadeaway left of the lane over Regan. Leaves it short. Watson pulls away the rebound for Buffalo. Jim Kwichoff, Bulls assistant coach, waving his arms. Wants that team to slow down as they move it up the court. McCray works it around to the left for Skeet. Top of the key, Regan. Back over to Skeet in the left. Fakes right, dribbles left, from the wing to the lane. Gets under the basket, tries to flip it back to McCray, finds him on the right. His shot is blocked by Booth. They're going to call a held ball, and the arrow favors Toledo.
That was the right call there. I'm not sure if that was a pass by Skeet or a shot, but Javon was able to corral it in, but then just got tied up there by Booth. And a good block by the big guy.
Skeet made a nice drive, but he got too far under the basket. And now Regan is coming out. Cameron Downing takes his spot. Two teams tonight not playing too many guys off the bench.
Yeah.
Told you earlier, Toledo gets virtually all of their production from six players. Deep on the right side, Buckley. Buckley on the dribble now against the shorter Watson. Gets to the free throw line. Now probes the right side of the lane. Puts up a runner off the backboard. It's blocked by McCray. And then Buckley fouled him trying to get the ball back. First foul on Buckley. Javon McCray there gets credit for the swat. 40-27 Buffalo, 16:09 still to play at Alumni Arena.
Yeah, just keep an eye here on Jaron Skeet. Kind of, he's been wincing a lot ever since that last play at the other end. want to keep an eye on him and see if he's okay.
Way out top, Cameron Downing, right wing to Skeet. Now Watson between the circles. The senior from West Palm Beach, Florida, finds Downing out top. Right sideline now, Skeet. Pulls up, shoots a three. Bricked it off the backboard, no good. McCray tried to poke the rebound to a teammate, but it was snared instead by Buckley. Now Brown pull up three left of the circle, around and out. Downing the rebound for Buffalo. Got a timeout coming up, next dead ball. UB 40, Toledo 27. Right wing, New Arianc, fakes right, dribbles left. Goes foul line, McCray dribbles by a defender. Left hand slam dunk for Javon McCray. 42-27 UB. 14 points, 14 rebounds for McCray. We might have gotten a knee in a spot. You don't want to get a knee on that last dunk.
Yeah.
Left high post, Booth shoots a 15-footer and drains it right over the top of McCray, who's not moving right now real well, and I can't blame him. Got a knee to the midsection as he went in for the dunk that last trip. And now an injury timeout. Javon wincing as he walks off the court. I think he got a knee in the midsection. This is going to lead to an official's timeout. With 15:02 to go, we've got a break. 42-29, the Bulls are leading Toledo. And we'll return to Alumni Arena right after this. You're listening to Buffalo Bulls Basketball on the UB Basketball Network. That was a media timeout, wasn't it?
Okay. Yeah, it goes to media.
Okay.
Yep. Either way, it would have been a full timeout, but.
Right. We didn't call timeout, though. Yeah.
No.
Thank you. Wow, look at, I mean, Smith 1-for-7, Buckley 1-for-7, Pearson 1-for-8.
Just ice cold. 2-for-11 from three.
I got something coming back, all right?
I'm going to read this first, though.
Okay.
Riverside Federal Credit Union, for your family, for your future, for your profit, with offices in Buffalo and Gettysville. 42-29, the Bulls lead, 15:02 to go here at Alumni Arena.
Yeah, now with 14 points, Javon McCray has just passed Rick Coleman for 11th place in school history in scoring with 1,281 points. Rick Coleman played for the Bulls from 1887 to 1991. Six more points, and he'll reach Curtis Blackmore. Number 52's jersey we see hanging in the rafters here for 10th place in school history.
Blackmore right now squarely in Javon's sights. UB ball into our left against that Toledo man-to-man. Regan head of the circle, swings it right to Orem. Top of the key to Downing. McCray right now on the bench. Now give and go. Downing to Watson, back to Cam in the lane. A right-hand turnaround won't go. Pearson rebounds, now streaks down the court on the dribble for Toledo. Takes it all the way to the basket. Banks a runner in from the left side, as Pearson did that all on his own.
Yeah, I think he started to get frustrated. Instead of settling for jumpers, he's going to start taking it to the basket.
UB's lead is 11, 42-31. See how long McCray is on the bench after taking, I think, a knee in the midsection on that last trip.
Yeah, he said he was fine to coach, so he'll be fine.
Right sideline, New Arianc, headed the key to Downing. Now left wing, Skeet. 12 to shoot. Skeet drives into the middle of the paint. Throws up a wild runner and got the ball to dribble through. A wild shot by Skeet, but it went. He has 11 now. 44-31.
Not sure that's how they drew that one up, but it's 2 points nonetheless.
He got the roll. He kind of threw a line drive runner toward the rim and hit the lip of the rim and just kind of peeled over and dropped. Pearson outside right against New Arianc. Now to Reese Holiday between the rings. Swings it left to Brown. Left corner, Lemons. Underneath now to Booth, the freshman, working against Downing. Has to throw it back to Bruce, resetting. Good defense from Downing. Bruce around a ball screen from Booth. Now flips it back to Booth. Head of the circle. Jumper good from 18 feet away.
Yeah, well, he can really knock down that outside jumper. That's three or four he's had already tonight. He's a really good player.
I tell you what, Booth is going to be a real good big man in this league. Only a freshman. Watson pull up three right wing. Swish! Tony Watson, I think, had a screen there from Regan on the far side and then drained his second trifecta of the night.
I think it's Tony Watson's officially out of his shooting slump.
47-33 Buffalo. Tony 15 for his last 29 from three before tonight and two for four at the three-point arc this evening. Pearson runner from the left. No good off the backboard. Rebound out of bounds off Regan, I guess, for Buffalo, so it stays with Toledo. Fresh shot clock now for the Rockets. 13:05 to go in the game. It's a 47-33 UB advantage. Cintas, the service professionals, sponsor UB Hoops. Call 1-800-CINTAS-1 for all of your uniform and facility service needs. Inbound pass gets launched out to midcourt. Reach Holiday almost went over and back right there in the Bulls logo center of the floor. Now Pearson headed the key, drives down the left alley, puts one up off the glass, no good, and Tony Watson wrestles away the rebound for Buffalo. Bulls now out rebounding Toledo, 32-24. Regan between the circles, swings it left for Nwariank on the wing. Top of the key to Downing. Now right wing Skeet tries a set shot three. Oh, yeah! Jaron Skeet's second triple of the game. 14 for Jaron Skeet. And a timeout called by Toledo. We'll take it with Todd Kowalczyk. Still 12:38 remaining. And the Bulls are ahead of Toledo by 17 points. It's 50-33. We'll return to Amherst in a moment. You're listening to Buffalo Bulls basketball on the UB Basketball Network. Yeah, no kidding. He's already got it. It was 13. He's got. No, I think it was 13. Oh, he might have. You might be right. Huh? Yeah, I think you might be right. Yeah, you're right. But he's... Look what I just got this from Doug Ganaki.
That's funny.
Huh?
That's funny.
Yeah.
No, I'm good.
UB 50, Toledo 33. Still 12:38 remaining at Alumni Arena at M&T Bank. They understand what's important. If you raise the green flag for more convenience on the go, there's M&T web and mobile banking, so you can bank and pay your bills where and when you want. Stop by any M&T Bank branch or visit mtb.com for details. Along with John Fuller, I'm Josh Wetzel. The Bulls shooting 53% for the game. Toledo still just 29%. Well, UB's turned in a tremendous defensive performance tonight. Right wing, Juice Brown with the ball for Toledo. Operating against Skeet. Downing comes out for a hedge. Now Brown dribbles at the free throw line. Pitches it left to Buckley, throws it behind him. Buckley has to save it, but Watson has it for Buffalo. Drives the other end, gets wrapped up by Buckley. And now Tony will be going to the line for two free throws. Close to a flagrant foul one that time on Buckley, instead just his second. And now the dead-eye free throw shooter, Tony Watson, goes to the line to try to pad this Buffalo advantage.
Toledo just seems really out of sorts right now, almost like they're in panic mode. There's plenty of time left in this game, but they're really rushing a lot, and I think, you know, that's what led to that turnover there. But it's just the second turnover for Toledo. It's done a pretty good job taking care of the ball.
That's amazing. Tony Watson switches the free throw. When you hear that Toledo has only two turnovers in the whole game, well, you wouldn't expect that the Bulls would be up by 18 and now maybe 19.
Right.
Toledo as a team, though, does not turn it over very much in the season. Watson cashes the second as well. A dozen now for Watson, who came into the game averaging right around 12 points a game his last five. UB's up by 19 points. Right of the lane, Pearson bumped from behind by Nueria. Orem's second foul. There have not been a ton of whistles in this game, really, for either side. The only man with any big foul trouble would be Nathan Booth for Toledo, who's on the bench right now with three fouls. Richard Wannell is in there playing the low post for the Rockets. Pearson head of the circle, squares up on Nueriang, tried an entry pass, tipped by Orem and stolen by UB. Good defense again by Nueriang. Skeet outside left, between the circles to Orem. They reverse it over the right wing for Watson. Now Downing head of the key. Left sideline to Orem. Bounces it down to Downing, who fumbled it away in the blocks. He recovers now in a double team. Spots up Watson, shoots a three, switch! Watson, another trifecta. 55-33 Buffalo. It's an 11-0 UB run. What a performance tonight by the Bulls. Buckley near midcourt. Drives on Watson to the lane, finds Pearson right baseline, faked the shot on Nueriak, now guns it out front for Brown, who tries a three and buries it. Brown's three-pointers is second of the night. He has 8 points. Pearson now almost looking a little bit gun-shy offensively against Nueriak.
Yeah, no question about it. Just the third. Toledo now just 3 of 12 from beyond the arc after that three.
UB ball right to left. Left wing Nueriak, Buffalo by 19 points. Down in between the circles, flips it right to Watson, headed to Key Regan. Left wing Nueriak drives to the lane on Pearson and draws a foul as he was flying toward the basket. So Orem is going to be shooting free throws when we come back after this break. That's the second foul on Pearson. 10:50 to go in the game at Alumni Arena, and the Bulls lead Toledo 55-36. This is Buffalo Bulls basketball on the UB Basketball Network.
Alright, it is now time to play Buffalo Wild Wings Chicken in a Basket Contest. And our two teams will compete to see who can catch the most rubber chickens in their fryer basket in 30 seconds. And each member of the winning team will receive a $20 gift certificate for Buffalo Wild Wings. Now the white team is Vincent and Nicole, and they're playing for section 201. And the blue team is Maggie and Jason playing for section 110. And you're going to want to cheer on your teams because a winning section is going to get a coupon belt at Buffalo Wild Wings. All right, guys, are you ready? 30 seconds on the clock. Get set. Go. All right, chickens are in the air, and we are underway. Whoa, big arcing throw for the white team here. Looking good so far. And we are 10 seconds in. And see what's happening over on the blue side. Not bad over there either. All right, 10 seconds left on the clock, 10 seconds. And we're down to 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and that is it. And let's see what we got. The white team, we got 9, and the blue team, 5. All right, so it is the white team. Congratulations.
Geico sponsors UB Hoops. Geico is saving people money on more than just car insurance. See how much you could save today. Buffalo is ahead by 19 points at home over Toledo, 55-36. 10:50 to go. This Toledo team has won 5 in a row, tied for first in the MAC West with Western Michigan. It's just been a brilliant performance so far tonight for UB.
Yeah, especially defensively. We talk about, you know, how well the Bulls are playing on defense, but they're not really doing it with causing turnovers and steals. The Bulls only have 2 steals, only cause 3 turnovers. But I think their closeout defense is, you know, Toledo's only shooting 15 of 50 from the field, and their interior defense has been spectacular. The Bulls have 6 block shots already. Javon has 3, Will has 2, and Xavier Ford has 1. So they're really just doing a great job on the inside, forcing Toledo to take some, a lot of contested shots.
Orem Nueriak gets the bounce in his first free throw of the night, and it's 56-36 Buffalo. Orem has 6 points, but his biggest contribution has been made on the defensive end against Ryan Pearson. And now a second foul shot, in and out. Rebound to Booth for Toledo. Nueriak now 24 of his last 29 from the free throw line. pull-up three from Buckley, head of the circle. Back iron, no good. Long rebound into the corner, and Skeet lets that carry out of bounds back to Buffalo. So UB with the ball and a 20-point lead here on the scoreboard. Bulls will be on the road Saturday, a 3:30 tip-off at Miami. That's a little bit of a game-time shift to accommodate a television broadcast. Downing top of the circle. Javon McCray, by the way, back in now after getting the wind knocked out of him. Skeet drives down the right alley, has his shot near the rim, blocked out of bounds by Booth. One freshman blocking the other. And UB still with it, right at the glass. 17 seconds on the shot clock. McCray, 14 points, 14 rebounds. 14 boards match a career high for Javon. In it comes to Nurink on the right. McCray wants it down low against Booth. Instead, Orem drives down the paint. And a whistle and a foul going against Booth. Number four on Booth. Four fouls on Booth, who has 10 points. We'll see if Todd Kowalczyk keeps him in.
Doesn't look like he's going to his bench here. He's going to keep him in there. So if you're UB, I think you just want to just go right at him. Get the ball to Javon and then take it right at him.
And it comes to Watson. Fakes a deep two left side. Now he launches after his defender flies past him. Tony missed it too strong. Smith the rebound on the weak side, and he got fouled by one of the Bulls who had him sandwiched. That's against Cameron Downing. Foul number one tonight on Cam.
Wait, are we in the second half and Cameron Downing only pick up his first foul? That may be a new record. All right, Cam.
That is a very good point. Bulls midway through the second half lead Toledo by 20. Matt Smith deep on the left has been quiet tonight, just 2 points. Brown between the circles, looks right, one hands it to Smith in the corner. Line drive three over McCray, won't go. Holiday, though, rebounds, and he gets fouled trying to put that up and in off the glass. Downing blocked the shot, but Nuerionk in front of him fouled Holiday, who now will go to the free throw line for a pair.
That's three now on Orem, which is going to be interesting if they bring him out. He tends to do a great job defensively on Pearson, but they may have to bring him out with three fouls. But that eighth offensive rebound there for Toledo. They already have eight, make it nine now with a good free throw, second chance points. That's the one area the Bulls really need to clean up to make this a perfect night. But if they can, they just need to do a better job on the offensive glass or defensive glass for them.
Nuerionk does come out. Corey Rayleigh Ross is in. Holiday with one more, an 80% free throw shooter. And this one is on the way and good, so he makes them both. And it's 56-38 Buffalo.
Not a lot of free throws in this game, Josh.
No.
That was just the sixth free throw for Toledo, and the Bulls only shot seven.
Corey Rayleigh Ross in full court pressure lost the ball to Smith, who had a layup staring him in the face, but he could not maintain control of the ball and lost it out of bounds, but one of the Bulls touched it last. Now the Bulls just turned it over facing full court pressure. And now Matt Smith inbounds it to Josh Lemons, head of the key. Lemons just came in off the bench. Buckley, left side, long NBA three in the air and good. Right over the top of Javon McCray. 6 points now for Buckley. And Jaron Skeet having trouble in the backcourt. Dribbles out of a double team and gets into the left forecourt.
It's the first time Toledo's really showing this full court press. It's giving UB some problems.
And the Bulls call timeout. UB is facing some tight pressure, as you mentioned, for the first time tonight. Looked a little bit out of sorts there and wanted to make sure Toledo does not get any momentum going. The Bulls bench calls a timeout. Still a comfortable lead, but what was at one point a 22-point difference has been trimmed out of 15 at 56-41. Toledo in the midst of an 8-1 run right now. Bulls still with three timeouts left. And the same complement of timeouts remaining as well for the Rockets. Hey, for a limited time, enjoy two great tastes on one plate with the new sirloin and crab stuffed shrimp at Carrabba's Italian Grill. Carrabba's Italian Grill, a sponsor of UB basketball. Wannell, Smith, Holiday, Buckley, and Lemons are on the court for Toledo, and the Bulls have Skeet, McCray, Watson, Downing, and Rayleigh Ross. Skeet inbounding right in front of us. Still looking, and now guns it in McCray, left corner. Gives it back to Skeet, a little give and go, and Jaron got tripped up and shoved by one of the Rockets. That's the sixth team foul on Toledo. And the foul is against Buckley, his third. Now, you and I were both noticing as Jaron got ready to inbound that. Looks like he's still wincing a little bit.
Yeah, I'm not sure
what happened.
It was earlier on that on the play under the basket. He started limping back towards the other end.
Underneath Downing, tried to reverse layup left to right, got blocked. Winnell pulls away the loose ball for Toledo.
Yeah, and he's still wincing a little bit, but not enough to come out of the game.
Smith low right. Now right high post for Winnell. They reset to Buckley. He'll try a longer three this time, and he buries it. Boy, that was from way out there from Buckley. And now it's 56-44. UB's lead is a dozen. Buckley has made two straight NBA threes. That one was from way out there. Right side, Rayleigh Ross. Give and go to Downing. Right blocks. Stepped by Winnell. Lays it up on the backside of the glass and scores. Draws a foul, and now Downing will go to the line.
That's just what the Bulls needed there to kind of stop the bleeding. Toledo was on an 8-0 run there. Nice and one by the big fella. Well, that's one thing. Cam Downing, when he's around the basket, he's so good at finishing. And that was a big bucket there.
70% from the field on the season. A little give-and-go action that time for the Bulls, and Downing used the rim to help protect himself. Laid it up, drew the foul from Winnell, who's now out of the game, replaced by Nathan Booth, who's back in playing with four fouls. 58-44 UB, and now Downing going for the and one. Puts it up, and it's in and out, and back in again. And now Downing coming out after converting the three-point play. Will Regan takes his spot.
Again, though, that's, you know, Cam has 5 points. That's all the Bulls' bench points. They really need to find somebody else that come off the bench and get some points for him, not so much rely on the starters all the time.
Pearson head of the circle, high left for Juice Brown. Brown now at the top of the key. Lobs it for Booth, right blocks, turns immediately on Regan, banks it up and off. Tip tried by Holiday, won't go, and McCray is able to pluck away the rebound. 15th rebound for McCray, and
that a, lost a
an
Will
official
lost a
timeout.
Contact.
Yeah, Will Regan had his left contact pop out. Pat Driscoll, one of the officials, noticing that. Now Will plugs that contact right back in. 8:21 to go, 59-44 UB. Toledo showing a bit of full court man-to-man defense. Regan's going to be inbounding it for UB. He cannot run the baseline. And Will looking for someone to throw it to. Guns it in to Rayleigh Ross at the far side. Jumps a tip pass back over to Regan. Regan ahead now to Skeet near midcourt. Guns it to a cutting Rayleigh Ross. Feeds it right to Watson, who pump fakes a three. Now the Bulls slow it down into their half-court set.
Wisely pulled it out. Use some clock here.
Regan, top of the arc, dribbles to the left wing and hands off to Rayleigh Ross. 12 to shoot. Corey out of Charlotte, North Carolina. Guns it back out top to Watson. 7 to shoot. Tony, hesitation dribble, pull up three, left wing. Short, just missed. Brown tips the rebound over to Holiday for Toledo. Rockets down 15 with the ball. Brown drives in from the wing to the lane, challenges McCray and banks it in. 10 points for Juice Brown.
Yeah, a little too easy for Toledo. I want to give him some quick points like that.
59-46. UB ahead by 13. They were up by as much as 22 here in this second half. McCray between the circles. Right wing Watson. Hooks it around to Regan ahead of the arc. Now left wing for Skeet around to Regan. Pick. Still way out on the perimeter. He's defended by Holiday. Backs out near midcourt. Holiday's still on him. Now Jaron dribbles over to the right side. Turns toward the bucket. Feeds it over to Watson. Wide open for right side. Three swish. Another three for Watson, who has 18 points.
Fourth three of the night.
62-46 Bulls with 7 minutes to go. Brown shoots a three from the right. Leaves it short. Will Regan pulls away the Buffalo rebound. First board of the night for Will. UB with the ball leading by 16 points. Bulls now have hit 7 out of 15 three-pointers. Last two games had gone just 8 for 29 from three-point land. Skeet has the dribble out front on the right. This time Juice Brown is on him. Pulls up top of the key. Shoots an 18-footer. Too strong, and Booth pulls the rebound away from his teammate Holiday. Toledo left to right. Brown, the reigning MAC freshman of the year, bounce to Holiday, right felon extended. He drives on Regan at contact. Count the bucket, a bank shot went. Regan is called for the foul, and now Holiday will go to the line, trying to convert the three-point play. And a timeout on the court with 6:27 to play here at Alumni Arena. The Bulls lead by 14 points, 62-48. Bulls over to the Toledo Rockets. And you're listening to Buffalo Bulls basketball here on the UB Basketball Network.
to the Carol Harris Foundation. This organization is dedicated to educating including various career choices, such as joining the armed forces, attending trade schools, and or attending college.
And if you
and I am here with Aria, who is going to play the new era Canada Shuffle. Aria, you have a chance to win a UV Bowls new era cap, as displayed by Victor. Now, you know the drill, keep your eyes on the video board, watch the UV cap shuffle. When they stop, tell me which cap you think contains the basketball. All right, it goes up in the middle cap, and around they go. Keep your eye on that middle cap as it's working around. I'm going to come to a stop here. You're going to have to tell me, is it cap A, is it cap B, or is it cap C? All right, Aria, is it A, B, or C? What do you think? She says B. Let's take a look. And it is B. Congratulations. You've won a Bulls of the Era cap. There you go. All right, try that thing out. Let's see how it looks. All right, visit the New Era flagship store at 160 Delaware Avenue to get your favorite New Era cap.
GEICO continues to grow. They're still hiring for sales, service, and claims representatives. Apply today at geico.jobs. Along with John Fuller, I'm Josh Wetzel. 6:27 remaining. Buffalo 62 and Toledo 48.
Good to see the Bulls getting back on track offensively. The Bulls scored 62 points. That's the most since they scored the 91 against Central Michigan.
Reese Holiday is at the line trying to convert this three-point play. Holiday is from Kansas City, Kansas. Numbers have gone down a little bit ever since his freshman year, but his minutes have gone down a little bit. He's still really producing at the same rate as previously, just not getting quite as many minutes. It's the bounce and the free throw for his seventh point. Now he promptly leaves the game, replaced by Matt Smith. So the Bulls lead by 13. Full court pressure from the Rockets. The trap coming on Skeet, gets rid of it to McCray, and a head down to Watson in the left front court. Toney now in the near wing. Stops in front of the Buffalo bench. Regan between the circles got away with a walk. Left wing Watson looks toward Regan in a screen and roll. He's covered up to McCray, high post, trying to buzz it down to Regan, and it's intercepted by Buckley for Toledo. Bulls turn it over. 62-49 in favor of the Bulls. Left baseline Smith, backs beyond three, can't squeeze off a shot. Way out top now for Buckley. Launches one of those long threes again, this time short. Jaron Skeets all alone for the UB rebound, his fifth.
Yeah, I think we're at a critical time right here. The Bulls really need to put away Toledo. We saw what happened against Northern Illinois, where pretty much had the game comfortably in hand, and Northern got back into it late in the game.
McCray high post, left wing Nuerioc. Left corner for Skeet. Dribbles it back out top against Pearson, and then over to defend him Lemons, and Lemons reached in and fouled Skeet. It's the first on that freshman from Cincinnati. And the Bulls into the bonus now, a one-on-one chance for Jaron Skeet. Jaron had been in a real groove at the free throw line, but now with the last two or three games, only one for his last seven. Bulls as a team the last three games from the line, just 57%. Not too many free throws overall tonight from either side as Skeet's free throw goes. Jaron has 15 points. 63-49 Buffalo. And now the next for Skeet. On the way, and that's perfect. A lot of Bulls having good games tonight. Skeet, one of them. 64-49 Bulls. Lemons on the right wing. Had Pearson open for a second, couldn't find him. Now he hands to Pearson, come up from the baseline there on the right wing. Pearson, top of the key, snaps it left to Buckley. Back to Pearson, head of the arc. Tries his first three of the night and swishes it. Just the sixth three-pointer of the season for Ryan Pearson.
And just the first in MAC play. He was 0-7 in MAC play on the season. First one he's made all year in MAC play.
Bulls by 12, 64-52. Deep in the left, Javon McCray. Watson now between the circles. High right, Regan. Right sideline to Skeet. Drive toward the hoop, all the way to the bucket. Fires it out top, Watson. He'll try a three. Oh, my goodness, he hit another one.
Oh, he is feeling it right now. Good for Toney.
Another three-pointer for Watson, and a new career high for Watson, 21 points. Smith on the dribble, throws up a wild runner, no, rebounded his own miss, puts it back up and off, but draws a foul. 67-52 Buffalo, but now Smith will go to the free throw line after getting hacked by Regan. Third foul on Will. And Smith, the best free throw shooter in the MAC at 90%, will go to the line.
I think Tony's shooting so well. You know, it is old school night.
Yeah.
And, you know, Tony was born way back in 1991, I believe. So, yeah, he's feeling a little nostalgic tonight.
Smith hits the free throw. Nothing new for him. He had a stretch of making 22 in a row earlier this year. Brown and Booth come back in. Buckley and Winnell go out. 67-53 Buffalo. Smith, who's now 48 of 53 in the season at the line, has one more. And it's around and in. Only 4 points, though, tonight for Smith, who is averaging over 10 a game in MAC play. And now he comes out. Reese Holiday returns. Bulls by 13 points, 67-54. They led by 10, 35-25 at halftime. Full court pressure being shown by Toledo. McCray throws it into Newark. Back to Javon. Zips it ahead to Skeet. Lobs it to Watson. Pull up. Well, he thought about a pull-up three from left wing, but he turned it down to take some time off the clock.
Yeah, wise move there by Tony. I know he's feeling it, but time's more important than 3 points right now.
Watson deep left. Throws it to cutting Regan all the way to the bucket. Lays it home from the left side.
That's what's great about this team right there. You get the inside and the outside. You have to respect Tony there with a three. Will was able to slip under there for the easy layup.
Pulled by 15, a double team on Brown. Pass deflected by McCray. Stolen by Nueria. And now Skeet tries to spike it off of Ryan Pearson in front of the Toledo bench. Missed him, and it went out of bounds. Yeah, and the Bulls turn it right back over to Toledo.
Yeah, I think Reggie was, the bench was screaming for a timeout. It was right at the end of the floor. The officials didn't hear it. I think they wanted Jaron to realize and just call a timeout there instead of trying to throw the ball off the defender.
Buckley comes in for Lemons, offense for defense. Brown inbounds it along the right baseline. Exactly 4 minutes to go in the game. He rainbows it out top to Buckley near midcourt. Back to Brown on the right. Lobs it to Booth right of the midline. He spins in on McCray. Turnaround shot off the glass. No good. Regan rebounds it for Buffalo. UB 69, Toledo 54. Skeet runs it up the court. Breaks across the timeline against Brown. Left wing to Watson. Out front for Regan. Swings it right on the wing to Nueriak. Headed to Key McCray. Now left side Watson. Way out top to Skeet. Right of the circle Regan. They spin it around to the right for Nueriak. Fry's baseline gets cut off by Buckley, and a timeout called by the Bulls with 12 seconds in the shot clock and 3:28 on the game clock. We'll keep it here in this timeout. Bulls by 15 points, 69-54 over maybe the class of the MAC West, Toledo. And it's a good year to beat Toledo. They think they're going to be really, really good a year from now when they have a couple of transfers eligible. Justin Drummond, the Metro Atlantic sixth man of the year last year for Loyola, and J.D. Weatherspoon will be active next year, a transfer from Ohio State. But this is a Toledo team that, you know, has had some talent. The Bulls have just had their number the last several years, and I think we were anticipating a very, very close game tonight, John. The Bulls have just outperformed Toledo in just about every facet tonight.
It just looked like the Bulls from the get-go has had a lot more energy than this Toledo team. You know, not sure why, but the Bulls have really been the high-energy team all throughout the night. It's showing.
And it's not over yet. Still 3:28 to go, but the Bulls are up by 15. Skeet throwing it in right of the hoop, having trouble finding someone. Finally gets it to Nueriak, right hash mark. Back around to Watson, left wing. Drives on Lemons, fires it to McCray in the post. Right side, Nueriak, wide open for a three, leaves it short. And Winnell rebounds for Toledo. Rockets from left to right, down 15 points. Buckley on the perimeter right, works against Watson. Stops the dribble, bounces to Smith, fakes a three on the right, drives the hoop, shovels it to Holiday in the middle of the lane. Shot blocked by McCray, grabbed by Javon. 3 minutes to go, and the Bulls have the ball after McCray, who's what, fourth block of the night.
Fourth block, it's 16th rebound. Incredible night for Javon. Kind of quiet offensively, but just you don't need him when everybody else is scoring.
Left side, Tony Watson, who's hit five triples tonight. Throws a pass down low on the left. Regan's wide open. Gets hammered by Holiday as he tries to lay it in. And Will Regan will be venturing to the free throw line after this timeout. It's 69-54 Buffalo with 2:44 to go. UB up by 15 over Toledo. And you're listening to Buffalo Bulls basketball on the UB Basketball Network.
Are you going on this trip?
All right, Ethan, you're going to get a practice shot.
I'm assuming you're going on the
real
bus.
Shots.
You're coming on the bus.
Let's see what you got. Practice shot coming up. And it's going to go a little right. All right, let's straighten that out. All right, real shot, ball number one. And here we go. All right, that is a off the rim. All right, Ethan, very, very close. You can do this. Come on, fans, let's hear it. He's going to put it in this time. And out to the left. All right, well, Ethan, just playing. You want yourself a large pizza for the Santoro's Pub and Grill at 1402 Millersport. Show your ticket stub after the game and receive half off any appetizer with the purchase of a meal. And now, fans, it is time for the Delta Sonic Super Kiss Cam. Show us the love. All right, which couple will be today's Delta Sonic Super Kiss fans of the game and win a Super Kiss wash?
Weddings, parties, dances, and more. M Entertainment and Productions is your one-stop shop for DJ, music, lighting, and event planning needs. Call 803-9715 today to take your event to the next level. That's M Entertainment and Productions, 803-9715. 2:44 to play. The Bulls 69, Toledo 54. Tony Watson, career-high 21 points. John McRae, career-high 16 rebounds. Jaron Skeet close to a career high. He has 16 points tonight. Now Will Regan shoots a pair of free throws for the Bulls. Regan, 1-for-2 at the foul line. He has scored 7 points. And the free throw here is perfect. 70-54 Buffalo. The Bulls haven't had too many 70-point plus performances offensively here lately.
No, not lately.
Second one, put a lot of arc on that one and hit it. 71-54 Bulls. Regan is checking out. Cameron Downing is in.
In fact, this is just the second time in MAC play the Bulls have eclipsed the 70-point plateau. They had a 91 points against Central. That's the only other time they went over 70 points.
Lemons penetrates, stripped of the ball. Rolls out of bounds off Lemons, UB basketball.
Again, Orem Nwariam. Just great defensive play to strip the ball there. He's really had a whale of a game.
How strange does it seem, by the way, to say that the Bulls only scored 70 points twice in MAC play? That seems very unusual. Buffalo native James Ewing is now in for Toledo with full court pressure being employed by the Rockets. The Bulls break it. Also, Brendan Schwiebert, a senior walk-on, is in there playing guard for Toledo with the Bulls ahead 71-54. James Ewing, a junior from Cardinal O'Hara, who then played at the IMG Academy for a couple of years. McRae kick out to Skeet in the left wing. Winnell stripped it from him. Steal for Toledo. Holiday into the right forecourt. 3-on-2 break. Throws it to Schwiebert, right corner. His three blocked by Nwariunk out of bounds. Orem Nwariunk's all over the place defensively tonight.
He's just played great. I mean, he only has 6 points. Kind of been quiet offensively. He's got 5 rebounds, 3 assists, now a block and 2 steals.
I mean, you can make an argument. Orem's been the most important guy out there
tonight.
Without
question. I mean, to be able to keep Pearson just 10 points, a very quiet 10 points for Pearson, who just 3 of 12 from the field.
Pearson not even in there right now. Todd Kowalczyk, hands folded in front of his chest, does not look like a happy guy, the head man for the Rockets. Under 2 minutes to go. Holiday left wing operating against Nwariunk. Kills the dribble, flips it to 1L. Pass deflected by Downing, but recovered by Toledo. Now Holiday head of the circle. Had a pass tipped by Nwariunk and stolen. It's like there's 3 Orem Nwariunks out there tonight.
Yeah, he's really.
UB ball up by 17, 90 seconds to play. Bulls will win it, fifth straight win over Toledo. And the 5-game winning streak for the Rockets will end tonight. Skeet from the left wing gets inside the arc, now takes it back out against Holiday. Try to pass to the right, deflected by Lemons. Grabbed by Skeet. Right, it comes for Watson. Stepping into a three, hit another one.
Why not?
Getting knocked down.
Why not?
74-54 UB.
The sixth three-pointer, which is a career high for Watson.
24 points, shattering his previous career high at 19. And now Watson called for a ticky-tack foul between the circles, knocking the ball away from Holiday. That's the second foul on Tony, team's sixth. With Toledo not yet in the bonus, the Rockets will inbound on the far sideline with 56 seconds to play, down by 20. Not shocked that the Bulls are winning tonight. I'm shocked they're up by 20 points, though.
Completely shocked, but I think this is how dangerous a team Buffalo can be when they're hitting around outside shots, and then you have players like Javon McCray and Will Regan on the inside. You know, they're flying all over the place, just playing with a lot of energy. That's all Reggie asked for, just play with a lot of energy, and you're going to get results like this.
Lemons top of the circle, shoots a guarded three over Skeet Swish. First points of the night for Lemons, and now Toledo calls a timeout or what? We've got
no, I believe there's just some players that were tied up.
Oh, okay. 74-57. Richie Seba-Herrera and Andre McPhail are coming in for the first time tonight. Javon McCray will leave, and so will Tony Watson. Yeah, so Watson with 24 points coming out. McCray, 14 points, 16 rebounds.
16 rebounds, the most by a UB player since Calvin Betts, you remember, at 18 in the quarterfinals of the MAC tournament back in 2009.
And now Skeet throws one out of bounds, facing full court pressure. Gunned it over the top of New Orleans' head and into the Toledo bench, the 11th turnover for the Bulls tonight. Toledo's only turned it over six times. Lemons between the circles, puts up a three, missed that wide left. Rebound, Winnell puts it back up and banks it home, and it's 74-59. 6 points for Winnell, and it comes to Skeet, trapped in the backcourt. Dumps it off back to Downing, and Skeet got wrapped up and fouled. And Jaron will shoot two free throws in the double bonus. Foul one against Lemons, the second on him. For the Bulls, Saturday play at Miami, trying to avenge that earlier home loss to the Red Hawks. And the next home game for the Bulls won't be until that bracket buster matchup on Saturday, February 23rd against Manhattan. Skeet's first of two free throws, around and out. One more for Jaron, who's close to a career high with 16 points tonight. His career high 19, his second foul shot, perfect. So 17 now for the freshman, 75-59. Lemons into that forecourt up the far sideline, shot clock is off. Guns a pass to Winnell under the basket, and he got fouled by Richie Seba-Herrera. He went leaping up into the air to try to block the potential shot. That means two free throws now for Winnell. Only 19 seconds ago as Winnell steps up to the line.
That's his first.
Yeah, I'm surprised the Bulls have handled Toledo this easily the way the Rockets have been playing, but I mean, the Bulls have just played a great game tonight, and the free throw is good for Winnell. Easily the Bulls' best game in a while.
I think it's even more impressive than what they did against Central Michigan, because Toledo is a much better team than Central Michigan. But I think, you know, from the get-go, they were playing with a ton of energy, and they were moving the ball really well, inside and out, side to side, and that's what Reggie really preaches in this offense.
Second free throw miss, McPhail the rebound for Buffalo. Now the Bulls can kill the rest of the clock. 75-60, Bulls will win it, and they knock off the Rockets, fifth straight year. Downing out front, hands off to Corey Rayleigh Ross. That's going to be it. The final score, Buffalo 75, Toledo 60. UB with the win tonight over the Toledo Rockets, and now we'll see what happens Saturday at Miami. John, thanks for the help tonight in the broadcast.
All right, Josh.
You're not going to be able to get away from the broadcast now the way the Bulls played tonight.
I know. I might be a fixture.
All right, that's John Fuller. I'm Josh Quetzal. Easy win for the Bulls tonight at home. Now we'll return to get our postgame show started. Right after this, you're listening to Buffalo Bulls Basketball on the UB Basketball Network.
Let's talk down to the player of the game, Jared Skeen. Jared, 17 points tonight. You guys really spread the ball around against a team that came in 7-3. 15-point win. Everything seemed to be going your way tonight. And not turning the ball over either. I think 11 turnovers on the night. That's a big deal for you guys to not give the ball away. They didn't play the game, didn't get you any points. It really didn't work for the ball over, but the dive over the corner there, it's kind of thing you know is giving your team energy and shows sort of the defensive commitment to effort that you guys need to play with night in and night out. Thanks, Jared. It's Jared Skeen, player of the game. Fans, thank you for attending Old School Night, presented by Unix and WBBC TV. Tune into the Bulls basketball postgame show on FM 102.9 and AM 1230 The Breeze on your drive home. We hope to see you back here next Saturday, February 23rd, when the Union hosts Manhattan.
Well, considering the quality of the opponent tonight and how well Toledo had been playing, I think tonight one of the best efforts of the season for the Bulls as they really went up cruising to this win tonight over the Rockets, 75-60. Just the second time in MAC play the Bulls had scored over 70 points. And although the first half featured six lead changes, really this was not much in question tonight. The Bulls were down 21-22 in the first half. All of a sudden go.